Ultimate Fighting Championship is looking to expand its reach in Asia, and who better to send as an ambassador than UFC welterweight champion George Rush St. Pierre? Now, GSP arrived in Manila yesterday for a three-day promotional tour, and he's a well-rounded fighter. St. Pierre built on his base of Kyokushin Karate, adapting other disciplines to become one of the best pound-for-pound mixed martial artists in the world. In fact, he has developed to become one of the best wrestlers in the UFC and dreams of one day representing Canada in the Olympics. Now, GSP has a series of appearances in the next few days, including a public workout tomorrow at the SM Mall of Asia. But first, he joins us right here, right now at Mornings at ANC. And we're also joined by Mark Fisher, Managing Director of UFC Asia. Good morning, gentlemen. Mark, George, thank you so much for being with us this morning.
Yeah, it's our pleasure. Thank you.
Like I said, Ginger, I don't think we've ever seen this many people in the studio. It is really such a treat to have such a big superstar of the UFC here with us.
Does it get old for you at all? I mean, how do you feel when you see such a warm welcome?
Oh, it was great. The first minute I step outside of the plane when I land here, it was amazing. I had a great welcome. The food is amazing. People are very nice, so I can't complain. You know, I'm having a great time.
It's right. UFC friendly, is it? The food?
Absolutely, very good.
Were you surprised at how popular the UFC and how popular you are here in the Philippines?
Yes, I was, because UFC never came here to have a show. They never had an event here. I know most of traditional martial art are Oriental. You know, I come from an Oriental martial art background, and I always wanted to come in Asia. You know, and coming here for me, it's a little bit a dream come true. Hopefully, one day I'll be able to fight here. It would be great.
Oh, we're looking forward to that. Right. Mark, is that in the books? Is that in the plans? Or is the UFC ever going to come here?
Well, I'd say it's maybe not in the plans quite yet, but certainly a goal to bring UFC events in the Philippines and across other key markets in Asia.
Cool. Well, I mean, going off of that, how is Asia as a market for UFC? I mean, we definitely see that there's a following for GSP and that there's definitely a following for the UFC, but how is it compared to other areas of the world and other markets?
Well, I think we're really just scratching the surface here. I mean, this is where the traditions of martial arts began many centuries ago. Mm-hmm. So in a way, we're bringing back, I think, the best of martial arts today in its modern form through the UFC back to Asia. So there's a tremendous receptivity here. We are on television, such as the Balls Network and other places around Asia, and that's the first step. The second step is to bring over some of our great stars, like George, to the area so people can see firsthand what great athletes these gentlemen are. And then eventually we'll go from there and build up some grassroots and bring some of the larger events.
Wonderful. So we can definitely expect to see you here again in the coming years or so?
Certainly, yes. We'd love to build. I was saying yesterday that I from what I've observed, Filipino fans are among the best UFC fans really in the world, pound for pound. And we really want to build on that passionate and intelligent fan base for years to come.
I know. I think you're going to see just how crazy we are about you know, the UFC and MMA in general. You're going to be giving a short demo. You're going to have
today,
a public
right
workout.
Now? I'm just
tomorrow. That's tomorrow. It's tomorrow. Yeah. And
what do you have planned for your 3 days that you're here?
Well, it's a lot of promotion, you know, and I'm very busy, but in my free time, I try to train as much as I can. I'm glad Manny Pacquiao's trainer, Freddie Roach, is here. Yeah. So he's one of my trainers in boxing, so I'll be working
gonna,
out with him a little bit.
Are you going to have the opportunity to hook up with him while you're here?
Yeah, I'm gonna go work out with him a little bit later on today with Freddie Roach. So, and also tomorrow I have a public training. I have a guy from Thailand who came. He's got more than 300 fights, so he's a professional fighter in Muay Thai. So he's gonna be I'm gonna be training with him. I invite all the fans to come, show up, and hopefully I have a chance to interact with them. It's gonna be fun.
Oh, they're gonna be there for sure.
That's right. You know what? Earlier this morning, there were a couple challenges that I was a kind of a part of. Some of the moves that you guys do, of course, did them very poorly. But there's really something wonderful about mixed martial arts, and that's because you've blended a bunch of different types of mixed martial arts, hence the name, but different types of sport.
Yes.
In it, what is the kind of dedication, the kind of practice when you really sign up for to be a champion in this league?
Well, fighting, it's more than physical. You know? Mm-hmm. That's what people doesn't understand. Fighting, it's not only here. It's mm-hmm. fighting, it's here. You know, it's all up. It's the mind game. You know, mm-hmm. I believe I'm champion not because I'm the strongest guy, not because I'm the fastest one or the biggest one or the more athletic. You know, mm-hmm. I am strong. I am fast. I am athletic. But I believe I'm champion because of my mind. You know what I mean? That's what makes the difference. That's what gives me the edge more than mm-hmm. the other guys, you know? And if you look at any other sport, like in boxing, it's the same thing, you know? Guys with the same physical attribute than I have, and maybe even if I take an example at Manny Pacquiao, they have guys of the same size. They could be just as strong as him. Mm-hmm. But the reason why he's champion is because of his mind. Mm-hmm. And that's what makes the difference in everything.
That's beautifully said. All so, right. Speaking of preparation and being in the top shape, you've got a fight coming up soon. Can we find out if how is that a continuous preparation? Is that just
yeah.
So not too many oily foods for you here in the Philippines while you're here?
Really?
No chicharron for you?
I'm lucky. You know, I can eat pretty much whatever I want. I don't get fat.
How many calories do you get to eat a day?
I don't even know.
You don't bother counting.
Every day, you know?
Don't bother counting. Yeah. I mean, let's go off that. I mean, people are really excited about looking forward, of course, to the December, when you go up against Josh Koscheck, once again, you've proven that you could best him on what people have called his best suit, which is wrestling. Are you going to be changing your game plan at all for December?
You know, I'm going to tell you the truth. I've been watching so many tape of Josh mm-hmm. Koscheck. I've been studying him. I know everything that I need to know about him. And mm-hmm. I found out even more day after day because I've been studying him uh-huh. very closely. I probably know Josh Koscheck even more than he know himself.
I mean, it's a perfect matchup, isn't it, Mark? I mean, you know, George over here has always been such an ambassador for sort of presenting such a more professional athlete image to mixed martial arts, and Josh relishes playing the villain. It's a perfect matchup.
It really is sort of the good guy, bad guy thing. Uh-huh. And knowing George, he also relishes that and not getting too into that game, as I'm sure he could tell you himself.
Yeah, this is mind game, you know.
It's all up here, like you said, right?
No matter what you say, no matter what you do, when the rings, when you hear the ring in the octagon, that everything is out of the window, you know. It's that's all matter to me. So I want to make everything possible to be the most well prepared I could be, and I'll be able to take care of business December 21 in Montreal.
All right.
Are there certain things that you do right before a match that, you know, has just kind of become superstitious? Is there something that you must do after, before?
I have like a little thing that I do at every fight. If you watch every of my fight, I make a quick prayer before mm-hmm. I step in, right before I step into the octagon. It's because I pray God to protecting me mm-hmm. and to protect also my opponent. That's one thing that mm-hmm. I do all the time. You know, because we all have family. No matter if I'm fighting the guy, if I like him or not, mm-hmm. I just hope we both at the end of the fight, no matter what happened, we both stay healthy and mm-hmm. be able to reach out to our family.
I thought it was a little bit more of like, I mean, do you like to sing? You know, like a song? I mean, is there a little bit of like silly,
oh boy.
Silly,
I'm
silly
pretty
things
bad.
That people don't really know
hey,
about
that
you?
Makes both of you.
No, I...
Ginger.
Hey,
Ginger is
say,
well
you know
known. Ginger is well known. She's in fact our pound for pound queen of bad singing on the
of
show.
Of karaoke. But you know, I was just wondering if there are some things that people don't really know about you, like you know, if you're a very big karaoke fan, if you dance.
Something that people doesn't know about me, I would say I'm not the fighter stereotype mm-hmm. guy. I'm more like a nerdy guy. Like I like to read. I'm really big into paleontology.
Oh,
that's something. Maybe there is something that people doesn't know about mm-hmm. me. That's mm-hmm. one of the things. I'm really passionate about paleontology, philosophy.
Like cool.
Everything that I've read, everything that I do outside of fighting is related to that.
Very cool.
Speaking of things that people want to know about you, we asked our Facebook and Twitter followers earlier this morning to submit their own questions for GSP for a chance to win UFC apparel. Now, here are the lucky five we've chosen.
Five.
JR29 asks, who has given you the most challenging fight and what adjustments did you do to ensure your victory?
The most challenging fight? First, sorry for my English, but I just want to know, did he want to know who gave me the hardest fight? That's what he wanted to do, or that challenging? It's like the hardest fight.
Mm-hmm.
The hardest fight of my career, it was back in Montreal when I used to fight on the local scene. It was not even in UFC.
All right.
I fought that guy named Thomas Dinny, and mm-hmm. I was very sick the day that I fought him. But I still step in, and I went to fight him. After the first round, I went. At the time, it was my third fight. I never went in the decision at that time. I didn't have a lot of experience, so I used to finish my opponent all in the first round. So I go against this guy, and I tried to take him out so hard in the first round. I put him down, used ground and pound, tried to submit him. Nothing worked. That guy survived. I go back at my corner, and I'm sick. I was even sick before the fight. I tell my cornerman, I'm like, I can't go back. I can't breathe. I'm so weak. I'm gonna fall unconscious. You have to throw the towel. And my cornerman look at me. He's like, George, I don't have any towel. You're gonna die in the ring. And then I'm like, I'm getting pissed off because my cornerman was supposed to be my friend telling me that. So I'm like, and at the same time, the ring. I hear the ring. So I have to go back and fight. So I got so pissed off that I went back and I beat the guy. But it was a really tough fight. At the end of it, I felt very dizzy, but it was a good experience. It teached me how to pace myself a little bit
That's
more.
A great story.
Fight.
The moral of the story is always have a towel with you.
The guy that I fought that day is not the more skilled guy that I fought. He's not the best guy that I fought, but he gave me the toughest fight because of the environment that I was fighting with.
Like you said, there's more to winning a championship and being a champion than just what's on the outside or maybe what seems obvious.
Exactly.
All right, we've got another question over